Sean, thank you very much, and welcome to the sold-out Dean Smith Center here on the campus of the University of North Carolina. With the BC win over Michigan State, the ACC is on the verge of wrapping up another ACC Big Ten challenge. It is some kind of loud here tonight, Dick, as number one Ohio State comes to Chapel Hill.
Well, we're going to see a lot of diaper dandy, six McDonald's All-Americans, some super young talent.
David Lighty is one of those great freshmen, has it knocked away from behind by Rayshon Terry, one of the few upperclassmen in the starting lineups for these two teams.
Buckeyes come in number one in the eighth in the poll, the coaches poll.
Long nice slide from Mike Conley Jr. to a fellow Hunter.
Hunter's a long, lean guy. He's out of Winston-Salem, went to junior college out of Tampa, Florida.
And he's got a big job in his hands tonight, and that is trying to contain the potential All-American, Tyler Hansbrough.
I think Hansbrough's going to have a big, big night. He was so focused in the practice session.
Dick, Ty Lawson starting at the point for Carolina. Bobby Frazier, who has been the starter, out with a foot injury, could play later in the game. Brandon Wright called for the offensive foul. Let's show you the starting lineups. If you haven't seen these teams yet this year, there are some new names, but they are great freshmen. Conley and Lighty, both freshmen for Ohio State. Ellington, Lawson, and Wright, all freshmen in the starting lineup for Carolina.
And the best of them all is not in the lineup. He'll be available to them beginning of January. Greg Oden, who I firmly believe he'll be the best big guy entering college basketball in over three decades.
And they'll have him back, could be 3 weeks, could be 4 weeks. They're not sure, certainly for conference play. Greg Oden is going to rejoin, or will join, the Buckeyes. The acrobatic scoop for Lewis, and Ohio State looking sharp early.
Lewis is a slasher. He's a driver. He went to Bowling Green. He was averaging about 17 a game in a Mid-American, and then decided to transfer.
Averaging over 17 points per game so far this season. Wright draws the foul. Thad Matta, and what a meteoric rise for him. A year at Butler, three at Xavier, now three at Ohio State, and he has got it all going on, and that's the biggest prize that he's got right now. Greg Oden, who shoots better with his left hand than a lot of college players do with their strong hand.
I'll tell you, put a show on today at practice. You and I were so impressed. They wanted me to challenge him a little one-on-one. So are you kidding me? I mean, I think he's the coming. We had Patrick Ewing, very similar, a defensive dynamo. People are not going to get shots in the lane against Ohio State. His commandment will be, thou shalt not enter thy lane.
Brandon Wright, the freshman out of Nashville, 6'9", 215, supremely talented. Foul is going to be called on Ivan Harris of Ohio State. Let's go to Doris Burke for more on Greg Oden. Doris?
Dan, I had a chance to speak with their team doctor, Grant Jones. He said, in his words, Greg is getting close. The target date remains January 1, but potentially mid-December, and guys, that Florida matchup looming right in that area.
Hey, Doris, if I was Mick Fronin of Cincinnati, first time they're going to play since 1962, I got a feeling.
Hansbrough splits the double team and draws the foul. He has a relentless will once he gets his hands on the basketball.
Hey, Dan, he's so tenacious. He wants the basketball. It was hard to believe he only had five shots. Look at him sitting in the post. Big and strong, good hands. He only had five shots against Gonzaga in that loss.
Then came back against Tennessee with 27 points. Had a little laugh with Roy Williams before the game. We asked him, is he the hardest working player you've ever had? And he said, well,
no, Michael Jordan.
I'm glad you finished my thought.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And he said, you know, Hansbrough takes care of his body and his diet, and he stretches before stretching, and his work ethic is phenomenal. He said, but let's get one thing straight. Nobody worked harder than Michael Jordan.
And he had a few gifts.
Yeah, he did. The three won't go down for Terry. The Tar Heels on the offensive glass, but it's ripped away by Conley, the son of the Olympic gold medalist in the triple jump, Mike Conley Sr. back in 92.
He's such a cerebral player. He's a great player. And he always did shoot the line.
We were so impressed at Shoot Around today watching Ivan Harris and Ron Lewis and Daquan Cook and Jamar Butler shoot threes. This is an outstanding shooting team.
Well, they average almost 11 threes a game.
Lawson is fouled by Conley. You talk about some quickness at the point. There aren't many in America quicker than Conley, but Lawson is one of them.
Well, Lawson's got supreme quickness. In fact, coming out of the high school ranks, Lawson was rated the number one point guard in America. Conley was rated in many of his services number three or number four. Also in there is Crittenden from out of Georgia Tech. DJ Augustine down there in Texas. A lot of good young kids.
This is Wayne Ellington.
Could shoot it. Can flat out shoot it.
A freshman, another one from Wynwood, Pennsylvania. It's his 19th birthday today. And I don't think we're supposed to know this. He told one of his coaches he's going to score 19 points in honor of his birthday.
Oh, why not 20? He can shoot
the rock.
Just
want to get greedy.
Hey, Dan, I'm going to tell you something right now. These two clubs are going to be legitimate contenders to be in Atlanta come March Madness.
Here's Conley. He snakes his way all the way to the basket.
Lawrence North High School, he and Odin together won 45 games in a row.
Look at Lawson flying down the court, misses the shot, but that's what Roy Williams wants, especially when Lawson's in the game. Get it down the floor as quickly as you can.
You think it's a little pride going against each other? I asked Mike Conley, had you played against him in high school? He said no. Well, they've read about each other. They know about each other.
Wright trying to back down Harris. And it is stolen away by Jamar Butler, the junior out of Lima, Ohio.
Look at that driving ability. Look at that driving ability.
Well, the Ohio State Buckeyes, even without their best player, and even with many people saying, well, yeah, who have they played so far, they have come in here looking rock solid in the early going.
Well, they look rock solid at the workout today, at the shoot-around. Supreme quickness to the goal, and we have not even seen, really, one of their premier players, Daquan Cook, who's a big-time scorer for them off the bench.
Averaging better than 17 points per game. Second foul on Brandon Wright. He will come out. Danny Green will come in. Carolina gets a little bit smaller, but Roy Williams, as all Hoops fan knows, he's got 11, 12 guys. They have tremendous depth, and they're in very little jeopardy of real big foul trouble.
Well, last game they blew out Tennessee, but he was concerned about the turnovers.
Yeah.
Had 26 turnovers in that game. Young kids are going to turn the ball over, especially when playing at a fast pace.
Hansbrough with a jump over Matt Terwilliger, a junior from Troy, Ohio, who's checked in the middle for Ohio State.
Terwilliger's a very physical player. Hansbrough so skilled offensively.
Terwilliger did play against Hansbrough once in high school, so he knows what he's in for. Ivan Harris open again, misses the three.
That has got to get going for North Carolina, is Terry. He had a big year last year.
Dick, last night we had a 54-51 game at Cameron. It could be 54-51 by halftime here tonight, the way these two teams get it up and down.
You know, a lot of people critical of that win by Duke saying how poorly they thought they played. My feeling is they demonstrate a lot of character. If you could shoot 23% and a half and survive and win, that tells you a little bit about the character of your kids.
This is Ellington. They'll get way out on the perimeter on him. Daquan Cook, number 31 for the Buckeyes, has checked in now. The three from the corner for Ty Lawson.
Hey, did you ever hear Wally Pipp? There, Wally.
You're pinning that on Bobby Fraser.
Wally Pipp, yeah. I love Fraser. He has a place for him, but it's going to be tough to keep Lawson on the bench. Just like it was tough to keep Lee Garrett.
Jamar Butler with an NBA range three, and it's 15-9 Buckeyes.
He's rotated into a new role. Last year, he was playing the point. This year, he's over the second guard. They really play with 2 point guards.
Making room for Conley, the freshman, to be the primary point guard, and Butler has handled the transition well. A turnover.
That's been the problem for North Carolina.
And Lewis will go to the line.
You know what's impressed me right now, and I'm going to be honest with you. I thought they might have been a little bit in awe and intimidated of the museum and playing North Carolina. There is no intimidation for those kids from Columbus.
Tonight's game is being presented on ESPN HD, presented by Olivia. Back here in Chapel Hill, what a start for Ohio State, leading 15-9. Although the challenge is over, BC has won, Virginia Tech has won, the ACC has now won all 8 ACC Big Ten challenges.
Well, you know, Dan, I really think when you look at the ACC, only 4 teams in the tournament last year. I thought that really wasn't fair. I thought Maryland and teams like, you know, you look at Maryland, Florida State, you're better than 500 or 500 in the ACC. You belong in the big dance. I thought Maryland was impressive when it went out of Beckway to beat Illinois, to end that big win streak on the road with the Orange Crush. Great win, and a salute to Gary Williams and his kids.
The Buckeyes have been impressive in the early going. Ron Lewis, the senior, misses the first free throw. You talked about the 2 years at Bowling Green. Go back to his senior year in high school.
Sixth man.
He was the sixth man. Now here he is scoring 17 points per game for the number one ranked team in the country.
That was out of Brookhaven right there in Columbus, and he was really under the radar in the eyes of many of the evaluators. They had Drew Lavender on a team, getting poorly out of our 20 last night.
Bowski was
Penn
in
State.
Oklahoma for a while. Yep. Marcus Guignard, number one. Wes Miller, number 22. Now into the game for North Carolina, along with Deion Thompson, another one of those freshmen. Again, Carolina extremely deep, and with the pace they play, they'll shuttle people in and out. And that guy, along with Ellington, Wes Miller, is their best shooter.
You can't give him an open look. He brings shooting ability. He got an open look. Poor job defensively by the Buckeyes finding him. Scouting report certainly indicated he could shoot the ball.
And Miller will play the two, but with Frazier potentially out with a bad foot tonight, he might have to back up Lawson at the point.
I think Miller's going to give him a big lift. Look at this kid.
This guy.
Look at this kid. Are you serious? Are you serious? I mean, when I saw Kenny Anderson at Georgia Tech, I jumped out of my seat and I couldn't believe it.
Well, you asked Coach Williams before the game, compare Lawson to Raymond Felton. Why don't you give us a comparison between Lawson and
Felton? Look at this. Change of direction and speed. I'm a big Raymond Felton fan. I love Raymond Felton. He was such a talent. He's a winner. I mean, this kid's got to go a long way to be able to achieve what Raymond did, but he's got the skills and he's got the ability. I think he can be as good as he wants to be. That's the kind of the indication I got from Roy Williams.
Second foul on Ivan Harris. He'll go to the bench as some subs check in for the Buckeyes. Let's go to Doris Burke.
You guys have been talking about how deep Carolina's roster is with all of that talent and Roy Williams' proclamation that he wants to average 100 possessions per game. He talked about those rotations. Danny Green, the sophomore, was quoted in today's paper as saying, we've got some guys who are uncertain of what their roles are. To which Roy Williams told me, hey, I have standards. Nine guys typically I use in my rotation, half of which are done by the seat of my pants, and half of which the players do, guys, raising the fist to indicate they're tired. He told his players, listen, sacrifice for the name on the front of the jersey and worry about nothing else.
Doris, Daquan Cook with a three for Ohio State. Hansbrough can't answer with the other end. Lawson's gone to the bench, and Bobby Frazier has come in for the first time tonight despite the sore foot.
I'll tell you one thing, Cook is a big-time scorer.
These guys can shoot the ball. That's David Leidy.
They can flat-out shoot threes. Another Piper Dandy.
And a guy known more for his defense and versatility. Using the glass nicely, Deion Thompson, the freshman from Torrance, California.
Thompson, nice little turnaround jump shot. He and Stevenson basically gets, you know, slide back in the eyes of people because of Ellington and Lawson and Wright.
These widely considered to be the two best freshman classes in America, North Carolina and Ohio State.
Well, if there's a better freshman class, I want to see it.
Frazier almost turned it over trying to find Miller. Hansbrough right into the double team, scoops it up and in. He's got five.
He does a great job of protecting the basketball, sealing the defense off. He and Odin went at it on ESPN in a high school match at Hinkle Fieldhouse.
And they both had similar numbers, similar scoring numbers anyways. They played each other, it would appear, to a virtual standstill. Listen to the noise here at the Dean Dome. Cook a miss. Hansbrough the rebound for the Tar Heels.
Frazier finds his buddy to go high-low.
Hansbrough from 17. And the rebound for Cook, who with the exception of Odin, might be the most talented player that Ohio State has.
Cook and Leidy give the rebound to Wing. Look at that little shake and bake. What a big-time move he made right there.
Everything but the finish for Mike Conley, Jr. This is some exciting basketball.
He's going to be a special point guard at Ohio State. His dad had that winner's mentality, winning the goal.
Thompson, count it, as Carolina gets back within three at 22-19.
Nice job by Thompson off the bench, providing some offensive firepower. Nice drive, good baseline move. Listen to the enthusiasm. There's the facing. Nobody rotates over on the baseline. I'm going to tell you something. Columbus is going to rock and roll. Chapel Hill's going to rock and roll.
This is high-level basketball being played right now by two very young teams. Ohio State leading 22-19.
What about the talent level that's on that floor?
Look at Conley again. And this time it'll go down. He is something else getting to the rim.
He is a big-time performer. You don't win 45 in a row in high school. He and Odin, three straight state championships. Lawrence North, they produced Eric Montrose.
Yep. McDonald's All-American Conley was. Skying for the rebound. Daquan Cook trying to do it himself. And the tip is up and in for David Leidy.
I'm telling you, Dan, these kids are way better than what I thought. I thought they're going to be good. They're a step above what I even thought.
They've played Kent State, Loyola Chicago, Youngstown State. But this is a big step up. It's also the first time. First time, that's right. They've been outside Columbus so far this season.
It's on the road.
You got to want it around the rim. I don't know who's going to get credit for that one. Maybe Alex Stevenson. He was in the vicinity.
I would give it to Stevenson. Stevenson, to me, got the tip. Stevenson and Thompson are going to be good additions.
And it is Stevenson who gets credit for the basket. Again, Carolina much deeper. Ohio State only has 8 healthy scholarship players.
I can't get over the pace of the game.
I know.
The pace is incredible.
Roy Williams wants 100 possessions a game, and already 3 times this year, Carolina has scored 100 points. Stevenson spins and is fouled.
He's got the kind of bench that he can utilize that can give him that. Transition, run, baby, run. That's the motto of tonight. Run, baby, run. Oh, this is showtime. I can't believe we get paid last night in here.
A phenomenal start to this game. Ohio State 26, North Carolina 21, midway through the first half. We've seen over the years so many outstanding big men playing for Carolina, beginning with Billy Cunningham back in the 60s, a guy you knew well.
Yeah, the Mac. Sam Perkins, Smooth, one of my favorites, Brad Doherty, who worked with us, J.R. Reed, very physical, Eric Montrose, tough around the basket, Rasheed Wallace, skilled, Sean May, a winner. What big people they have had.
Now, what about the guy right now, Tyler Hansbrough? Does he deserve, will he wind up in that class? And he makes North Carolina one of the best front courts in America.
Yeah, those are my 5 that I really like. You look at Florida, we love their front court. Florida and Ohio State hook up, by the way, later this month.
Now, let me ask you something. As soon as Odin gets healthy, does Ohio State go onto that list because of Odin?
Yeah, no question. You can put Odin, Schulman, and Vitale, and that'll be a great front court. Are you serious?
We need Burke to get us the basketball.
I watched him at practice today, and I sat there in awe. I talked to Lute Olson today, Rick Pitino today, Jimmy Boeheim, Mike Krzyzewski yesterday, and they were all unanimous in saying he's the best big player that they've seen arrive in the last 20 to 30 years.
If a positive can come from a negative, because he hurt his right wrist, he's been working on his left hand tirelessly in recent months. A couple of days ago, Coach Thad Mata told us he made 17 straight free throws with his left hand.
And somebody said, hey, Dad, we didn't know that he was lefty. He said, no, he's righty. I think Nick Cronin, watch out, Cincinnati. I got a funny feeling that he's going to be in uniform.
Certainly will be ready for conference play. Bad news for the rest of the Big Ten. Ohio State struggling to shoot recently, but Dick, at this pace, what's remarkable, Ohio State has not turned the ball over yet in this game. Deep range again. They are knocking him down as Ron Lewis buries another one, and he's got 9.
What an asset that is to have long-range shooters, and then when they get the post presence of Odin to stretch the defense.
Terry the miss, to Williger the rebound. I'm not sure I've seen a team take more shots during a game day shoot-around than we saw Ohio State take today.
Well, they said they learned that from Dick Hauter. Yeah. Dick Hauter was the assistant coach with the Pacers, and he went over to him and asked him some advice that Mata did. And he said, make sure your kids take a lot of shots. Don't just worry about the defensive end.
The Buckeyes 5 for 7 from three-point range so far tonight. Terwilliger is fouled. Time now for a SportsCenter 30 at 30. Here's Dave Revson.
All right, Dan. Falcons QB Michael Vick has been fined $10,000 by the NFL for an obscene gesture he directed towards fans after the Falcons lost to the Saints. Vick will also donate $10,000 to charity. And the fired Larry Coker will coach one more game for Miami, the school accepting a bid to play in the MPC Computers Bowl against Nevada on the blue turf in Boise December 31st. Details, SportsCenter after the game, ESPN News, anytime. Dan?
I'll tell you one thing. There's no way that the kids in North Carolina are going to back away. They're going to keep challenging and challenging as they reflect the personality of Roy Williams, who's a fighter, and they're certainly talented enough. But I think that they're really surprised at some of the Carolina fans with the unbelievable effort that we're seeing today out of the Buckeyes here.
Well, the Carolina fans were chanting overrated before the game even started, and I think they might want to take that one back at least 10 minutes and change into the game.
To me, with Odin, it might be underrated.
It's hard to quantify what he's going to mean, but everybody agrees. There's a travel as Terry turns it over. Everybody agrees he's going to impact the game more on the defensive end initially than he will on the offensive end.
Just like Patrick Ewing. They were worth 20 points. John Thompson did a great job, magnificent, to really improve Patrick offensively. But he was worth 20 points just in that three-second area. His presence. I love Conley.
Lewis wide open again.
I love
Hansbrough
Conley.
Brings it down.
I love Mr. Hansbrough.
We asked Thad Mata earlier today, what do you like the best about Conley? What's his best attribute? He said his mind. He is just so smart the way that he plays point guard, even though he's a freshman. Hansbrough, no. Follow, no. Terwilliger brings it down for the Buckeyes.
They play so hard. Both these clubs play with a lot of emotion, a lot of intensity.
Williger is fouled. He's being pretty assertive, trying to get to the rim. Well, Saturday on ESPN, a great doubleheader. It's the College Basketball Hall of Fame Challenge at 3 Eastern to Gonzaga, which knocked off North Carolina last week, taking on Texas, and then Illinois and Arizona. Arizona, another one of those top front courts on your list.
Hey, you talk about some freshmen. Kevin Durant might be the best freshman in America right now without Odin. Such a talent at Texas. And I love Arizona's. I tell Ludosa today, your front court, you talk about a diaper dandy, Chase Buttinger, man, is special. He and Radenovich and Marcus Williams, what a front court. If they get great play out of Shakur in that perimeter, they're going to be tough to beat.
Wes Miller with a steal.
I got to get Miller some threes and looks. Tough pass to make.
Terwilliger with a good recovery, getting down the floor in a hurry to deny the lob.
I think rhythm and getting familiar with one another for North Carolina is a process they're going to go through. But they're going to get better and better as the season progresses.
Nice feed and the slam for Cook.
Cook is big time. Oh, what a big time performer.
And you talk about playing with two point guards on the floor. That was Jamar Butler with the assist right there.
You know, a lot of clubs have holes. They have places where you look at them. They have liabilities. I ask you one question. Where does this team have holes?
In the red or in the white?
In the red. I mean, it's unbelievable what we're watching out here.
Yeah, multiple ball handlers, a number of talented shooters. If there's a deficiency right now, they might not be as big and strong in the front court as some other teams, but when they've got Odin getting unwrapped as a Christmas present in a few weeks for Thad Mata, that's all going to change.
It's hard to believe they can sustain this.
With eight players.
It's hard to believe they can sustain the tempo and the efficiency that they're playing at early in this game, away from home, a bunch of young kids playing in a museum, playing against a talented North Carolina team.
They have won by an average of 26 points in their 6 wins so far this year, but again, they haven't really been tested by anywhere close to this kind of a competition, nor had they left Columbus before this game here tonight. Lawson back into the game for the Heels.
With young kids like that, not a bad idea to keep them at home. They may be the first school.
Ellington off the screen, the miss, and Terwilliger's doing some solid work on the glass.
They may be the first school to win the national championship in football and basketball the same year. I mean, that's a legitimate possibility.
Oh, there's no doubt.
Because football is going to win it. Football, they're going to win it. Troy Smith is big man on campus until Mr. Odom puts on those shorts.
Well, it has been a remarkable turnaround in a very short period of time for the Buckeyes as they have risen back to national prominence under the guidance of Thad Mata. Shot clock at 7. Lighty in a little difficulty right now. Cook, rather, puts up a tough floater that drops.
Might have got away with one. Push it off with that arm.
Largest lead of the night. And Terwilliger, the foul. Boy, does anybody get end-to-end quicker than Ty Lawson?
The pace of this game and the tempo of this game, Lawson has to be on the floor. He has to be on the floor to neutralize the speed and quickness of Conley and company.
Cook with the monster jam. Ohio State leads by 10.
Dave Revson in our Sports Center in-game studios. Virginia and Purdue, tie game, time winding down. It's Terrence Crump hitting the floater. The Boilers are improved. They win it by 2 over Virginia. BC beat Michigan State behind 30-10 from Jared Dudley. And Vautech led by as many as 16. They hang on to beat Iowa by 4. Guys.
Well, Dave, so the ACC has already won the ACC Big Ten Challenge, but Ohio State, what a statement they've made in the first 12 and a half minutes of this game. Shooting lights out, taking care of the basketball, running up and down the floor with the heels, and leading by 10.
Hey, you want to talk about winners? We talk about national championships. Dean Smith, 1982, 1993, George Lynch is in the house. But what about this winner at North Carolina? Anson Dorrance, the soccer coach of the women's team. 18 national titles, and they're right now in the Final Four, Friday and Sunday in Cary, North Carolina. They play UCLA, and the Fighting Irish play Florida State, and Notre Dame hasn't lost yet, but that's unbelievable. There's a great book out, A Man Watching, by Tim Cruthers. He used to write for Sports Illustrated, now teaches journalism here. They say it's an incredible book. I have not read it, but get it, A Man Watching, by Tim Cruthers.
Conley at the point for the Buckeyes. Two Ohio State players have a couple of fouls, both big guys, Hunter and Harris. So Matt Terwilliger is a key guy, and he's got 4 rebounds already, and he's playing some pretty tough defense on Hansbrough. Not only can they shoot, they can get to the rim. Ron Lewis doing a little bit of everything here tonight.
Well, you know, it's really surprising the way they're getting to the basket, and nobody's closing off the driving angle, rotating over. We saw that with Florida against Kansas.
11 already for Lewis, Dick. He's averaging 17. Green the pull-up from the elbow, and he's fouled. Lewis going to be Cook with the foul.
Lewis played at that Brookhaven out in Columbus. He's a slasher, a driver. Went to Bowling Green, played for Dan Dockage. Then he is taking the ball up strong to the basket. No one rotated over. You know, I was on a show yesterday. Chris Spielman does a phenomenal job. Football guy, Kirk Herbstreit, radio football guy. They're going to get some basketball guys on the radio here. I mean, Spielman and Herbstreit, they're telling everybody how great football is. Basketball is the best sport of them all.
Well, is it all right if we talk a little football in the second half? Carolina head coach is in the house tonight.
Wow, Butch Davis, we met him tonight.
Morris will talk to him early in the second half.
And at the T&M show now down in Columbus, Trussell and Mata.
There's Coach Davis on the right.
He'll utilize this environment to help him recruit. Oh, look at this.
Butler got to the rim pretty easily, but missed the layup. Lawson stumbles over the foot of Terwilliger. The kick in the corner, but the three rattles out for Ellington. The follow is put back in.
Continued with the follow. Yep. Did a great job on the offensive glass. He's a good, solid defensive player. They got to play on the defensive side. North Carolina has not played on the defensive side.
Nice backdoor feed. And Lewis has it taken away.
This might be a little spurt. Give it to Hansbrough. Dump it in the wall. Bring it to the big guy. Bring it to the big guy.
Rebound by Ginyard, and he's fouled on his way up. The Buckeyes wanted a clean block.
Whoa. I haven't seen talent on a floor like this in many a year. What talent on the floor.
Bad Mata incensed at the call as Terwilliger is called for the foul.
Look at the effort right here on the glass.
That was Ginyard the last time down.
Really getting up on the offensive boards. They get the foul on Terwilliger. He said, no, I had all ball. That model, like you said, did a great job with Butler, Xavier. Well, Xavier's got a heck of a program going. He's a really super guy, too.
And you know, his players, the kids are as nice a group as you'll ever come across, all coming over and introducing themselves. And
What about David Eagleholt telling us today, the director of operations, about their recruiting success for the future? Kufos coming in, the big 7-1 guy.
Kosta Kufos, who's one of the best big men in the country, he's signed on for next year in a class that's 5 deep and ranked as one of the best in the nation. And then Pat Mata's got 4 more verbals from juniors already.
And big-time juniors.
Danny Green fouls Ron Lewis, who is getting after it here tonight.
Do they look like they're having fun playing? Hey, really having fun.
Hey, we're going to have some fun Saturday night. We'll be back in Durham for Georgetown and Duke, a couple of ranked teams, Saturday night, 7 Eastern, over on ESPN2. Roy Hibbert and Jeff Green will be a stiff test for the Blue Devils.
Well, you know, last year in the second round of the NCAA tournament, if my mind serves me right, they beat Ohio State
by
18.
Yep.
And they went on and challenged Georgetown, Florida, gave Florida the toughest task of all in their run to win the national title. Hibbert and Green, as you said, Wallace, Summers, John Thompson III, beating up on his little brother. Pops didn't like it. Pops didn't like it.
Ron Lewis now with a game-high 13. Ohio State has led almost the entire game. They're up by 7 right now. Frazier's back in for Lawson.
They went to the zone, 2-3.
Which they hardly ever do. Coach Mata told us earlier today they played about 7 possessions and given up about 12 points on the zone, and we might not see it much more.
They better get out of it because North Carolina has some shooters from the perimeter.
That was Frazier.
He's a solid player. Frazier just plays hard, knows his limitations.
Cook from the corner with a line drive 3.
Is he a big-time scorer? He's prolific.
He is averaging almost 18 points per game.
He can shoot it.
24 minutes, Frazier again.
Get out of that zone. These heels are not going away, my friends. This crowd will not let them go away. Sammy Cassell, this is no wine and cheese anymore.
Lewis having a big first half. Green knocks it away. Frazier to the floor. Tar Heel basketball.
Oh, yes, sir. What a contest. This is special. Talent, talent, and talent. You can have chemistry. I want talent. You can have chemistry. I want talent. You can have chemistry. I want talent.
Welcome back to the Dean Smith Center, where this has been as good as it gets. Great defensive hustle by the Heels, and Hansbrough rewarded with a dunk at the other end. North Carolina on a run. Bobby Frazier hitting a couple of threes. An electric Dean Dome here tonight. Number 1 Ohio State leading number 6 Carolina 40-38 with better than 4 minutes still left in the first half.
I'll tell you, some other recruits, we talked about Kofis coming in. They also have Evan Turner from St. Joe's High in Illinois. John Diebler, a big-time scorer. He may break the all-time record. How about my former Buckeye, Jay Burson? 2,958 points. LeBron James, by the way, is 3rd in high school. Then they got Dallas Lauderdale coming in. Eric Wallace. Next year, they get Anthony Crater, a terrific guard from out of Flint, Michigan, as a junior.
Dick, they're taking a look at one of those Frazier threes to see if, in fact, it was a three or did he have a toe on the line. Looks like it's a three.
Looks like a three to me.
Yeah.
I got one eye, man, and that's my right eye. So when I'm looking at that telestrator, my right eye tells me that is a three. That's a three. Good bit of officiating.
What an environment for Ohio State to come in here again without their best player, Greg Oden, or a guy who figures to be their best player as soon as he steps on the floor. But the 8 guys who have put on the uniform and come out on the floor tonight have played some inspiring basketball. Now the Heels are answering, and Greg Oden, because of the surgery 6 months ago on the right wrist, does not have the wrap on that we saw during practice. All he can do is watch and count the days until he's healthy enough to join his buddies.
You know what I'm really impressed about his buddies? They really can break you down one-on-one. They really can exploit people defensively. And they're very difficult to try to zone on because of the way they can shoot the three. There's going to be a lot of magical moments and a lot of excitement. And if you don't have a ticket right now to get to the shop down there in Columbus, you are going to be in trouble. That ticket is going to be worth big, big dollars. You and I are going to be there in our game day crew. Jay Digger, one of us. Reese Davis.
January 27th will be at the shot as Ohio State takes on Michigan State. Another three. This is Leidy. And Ohio State is red hot through the perimeter. Miller Long. He's a good open shooter. And one of his rare misses when nobody's got a hand in his face.
You know, you talk about all the diaper dandies, but Butler and Lewis are the heart and soul of this team.
Offensive foul.
Out of control. Those veteran players really set the stage. And that's what's going to happen for Duke if they want to elevate their game. Paulus and McRoberts have to set the stage for the Diaper Dandies.
I'm Reese Davis. Coming up on the UPS Halftime Report, ACC dominance once again in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. We'll talk about why. A lot of big men putting on shows tonight. We'll talk about why the big man seems to have returned even without Greg Oden playing right now. A little duck power slows down some guys with some strong bigs in the middle. We'll see you at halftime. Digger, Stacy, and Jay will join me, guys.
Reese, thanks a lot. Looking forward to the halftime show almost as much as we look forward to doing this game here tonight. And what a game it has been so far. Ohio State leading by five. But remember, they have only eight scholarship players, eight healthy available scholarship players. Four of them have two fouls right now. Ohio State back in that zone again, Dick.
They're back in the zone trying to protect some players. Take some time off the clock as well.
Frazier knocked down a couple of threes against the zone in the last couple of minutes. Frazier's on the floor right now.
Nice pass.
They lost Ginyard underneath.
Great look. Frazier really knows how to play. I like the North Carolina team. I think they're searching for combinations. When Roy Williams finds the right combination, they're going to be a tough team to beat.
And we'll have a tie-up. The arrow will give it to Carolina.
They have taken some hit from Ohio State, and they're only down three. Watch this pass, the diagonal pass, right over the top.
Green to Ginyard, the sophomore saying, hey, Dickie V, don't forget about us, huh?
G&G, baby, super selves, G-squared. We saw G-squared from Butler.
Kids from Butler.
Yeah, they won the preseason IT, Graves and Green.
Green and Graves. How about this? 16 different players have scored. 9 Tar Heels and 7 Buckeyes.
Thad Mata doesn't like playing that 2-3 zone. He really would rather not play that zone.
Offensive foul on Ginyard.
Thad was charged with a timeout a little bit earlier because he asked for correctable error on that 3, the second one by Frazier. And since it was good, he gets charged with a timeout.
You know, with this kind of noise, and they do this a lot actually on the Ohio State bench, the associate head coach, John Gross, is up with a big card, a big sign. And he's writing the plays so the players can see it because they can't hear him. Another turnover, though. This is a 3 that would have tied the game.
That's his forte, shooting a trifecta.
Terwilliger running the floor. But another turnover. That's 3 in a row for the Buckeyes.
The tempo of the game, the pace of the game is going to create turnovers.
Green.
Oh, Green giving him a little spark. That's how you earn some playing time. That's your role. What's your role? Your role's to win. That's your role. I get a kick when players talk about, I don't know my role. That's nonsense.
Jamar Butler buries a 3. Dick, Ohio State is 8-for-12 from three-point range.
Will hurt you if I want to get some free tickets, because they're going to be unbelievable trying to get tickets to see that play.
Hansbrough almost seeking the contact, follows his own miss and has it knocked away. Got it back again.
Can you imagine trying to get a shot off the nail with Odie?
5-on-4 right now. Leidy misses a 3. The Carolina fans thought Hansbrough was fouled multiple times on the last trip.
You know, a lot of young kids like to see the Ohio State kids. Sometimes you can say bad shots, but you don't want to limit those kids.
Yep.
You don't want to take away the freedom of allowing them to do what they do best. But they're all going to take some bad shots.
Look at the ball movement. The quick passes from Carolina trying to exploit this defense. Frazier wide open. Bodies on the floor again. As Leidy and Hansbrough go tumbling to the deck. And the lob at the other end.
Oh!
As as Cook finds Lewis.
Lewis is some kind of player. If he's not all Big Ten, my friends, I can't imagine what that conference has. Lewis has absolutely been sensational here. Crowd upset when Hansbrough got fouled.
Ohio State on the road with a very young team, not only playing well, Dick, they are playing tough. Hansbrough battling his tail off like he always does, and Ohio State just swarming him defensively.
As Terwilliger, Terwilliger challenged him. I thought he got fouled right there. I thought he got fouled. No call. Look at this now. They'll flip it up over the top. And there's the jam by Lewis. Lewis and Butler understand how to play. They lost three starters in last year's team.
Including Miles, the player of the year in the Big Ten, Terrence Stiles. They've got eight scholarship players, as we mentioned. Four of them are new. Three freshmen and a junior college player. And that doesn't include Greg Oden.
You know, they didn't find out whether or not they were eligible for tournament play until March last year when the Big Ten tournament started. And if they weren't, when those NCAA sanctions came down, yep, Dan Mono was going to release the young kids and they could go elsewhere.
Hansbrough on the bench for the final minute of the first half. Off the fingertips of Green, he saves it.
I thought Hansbrough was exhausted from his effort.
He's 3 for 11 from the floor tonight. He's had to work hard for every one of them. Again, good ball movement, but another jumper missed. The follow is there for Deion Thompson, a guy who's lost about 50 pounds since arriving on campus.
He did a great job on the offensive glass. I can't wait to see Derek Carrington talk to Rick Pitino tonight. He lost 55 pounds. We'll see him in a Jimmy B Classic against Arizona.
Tuesday night on ESPN, Syracuse, Oklahoma State, the other game. Shot clock and game clock bang on here to end the first half, and what a half it's been.
It's been phenomenal. So intense. So many great individual plays. Look at that effort defensively.
Ginyard.
He can play Dick. Now he can play Dick. He beats him to the spot.
And that was all help from Thompson.
That was all created by Ginyard Dunn. He did a great job by beating to a spot. So many kids allowed himself to get beat on that baseline.
Now I think, Dick, they're going to look at the clock here, and I think they're going to put a little extra time back on. They might give him another second or so.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Roy Williams calls Thad Mata over. The officials didn't. Roy Williams just summoned Thad Mata to the scores table, and the two coaches are having a talk.
Roy Williams done an amazing job coming back here, winning the national title 2005, 28 wins a year while he was at Kansas. Was so much part of the winning tradition at Kansas before Bill Self took over. And oh, I love that Jayhawk team.
What a night they had on Saturday against Florida. Let's take another look as Cook gets it blocked. And they should get almost another second. I don't know if they're going to put anything back on. They were over at the scorers table. Brandon Wright's going to come in for Danny Green.
Probably trying to take away the lob from the inside.
Doesn't look like Ohio State's going to get any extra time.
They put Wright on there because they want to have a defensive player take away that basket. He knows they're going to try to flip it right up.
Butler's going to inbounds it. And now Thad Mata is hollering at one of the officials about something, and Mata's screaming, more time on the clock.
He wants 2 seconds on that clock.
And I think he's got a case. They appear to have looked at it but not done anything about it, but Mata's expecting more time. I want you to put more time back on the clock, he's saying.
He's 39, man. He keeps going like this. He's going to look 69. What a crazy way to make a living coaching. I mean, it really is. It tears your heart out. It takes the wives, causes all kinds of unbelievable moments for them, the anxieties.
I tell you, the coaches are sweating more than the players are right now. Butler to inbounds it for the Buckeyes. And I think we're going to have a shot clock violation.
Yeah, shot clock violation.
So as soon as they inbounded it, I guess they ran out of time. The game clock and shot clock looked like they were bang on, and the shot clock was not on at the time that they inbounded the ball. So we've got confusion all over the place with the clock in the last few seconds.
Well, the one thing we don't have confusion, we had a great first half.
Yep.
An incredible first half. This was entertaining. Call your friends up. The second half is going to be scintillating, sensational, and super.
Phenomenal shooting by Ohio State, an impressive performance in a hostile environment. They're up by four at the break. Thad Matas with Doraesburg.
Coach, tons of foul trouble. You played a lot of zone late in that half. What impact did that have on your defense?
Well, we got crushed because of our foul trouble. I mean, we were, you know, fouling shooters, and it forced our hand to go zone, and we got to find the shooters in the zone.
First big test on the road for your guys. They reacted well offensively. What did you like on that side?
Well, we got great kids. They're winners. And I think coming in this environment, you're right, it's been a great test for us. We got 20 more minutes to play.
Good luck in the second half. Dan?
Look at the sweat that Coach Mata has worked up, and I don't blame him. Ohio State up by four in Carolina. Phenomenal first
fantastic
half. Don't miss the second half. But right now, time for the UPS halftime report. Let's go back to Reese Davis.
All right, Dan, I'll tell you what, never let him see you sweat. Forget that. Gary Williams has nothing on Thad in that first half. Digger Phelps, Stacy Dales, Jay Billis here. Jay, tempo, though, is it favor North Carolina despite the score right now?
I think it does. I thought Ohio State was really the aggressor in the first half. They hit eight threes. They were very aggressive putting the ball on the floor. They settled for some jump shots late in the first half, though. But I do think that the tempo tends to favor North Carolina. Getting up and down means there will be more fouls in this ball game. More fouls is in favor of North Carolina. Carolina continuing to get the ball inside. They gave up 48 points, but they scored on their own. And they are better offensively, I think, than they showed in that first half.
And definitely the tempo does favor North Carolina in this game. You have to look at the bench production. You got Marcus Guignard coming in. Might be the best defender on this Carolina team. He comes in the game, makes a difference. Then you've got Deion Thompson, that other freshman. He comes in, makes a difference in the paint. And, of course, Bobby Fraser gave them some poise after they spelled Ty Lawson at the 14-minute mark. They have depth, and it favors them, as Jay said, the tempo.
Well, I just like three things about this Ohio State team. One, they are playing the Thad Matas personality. He's got those convinced the way he did Xavier kids on how they would just push the ball. What impresses me the most is how in transition they just get a rebound and dribble it down and try to score. The second thing they do very, very well, Carolina is not guarding one-on-one penetration to the hole at half court, let alone getting weak side help to that ball. And that's where Ohio State just has a lot of confidence, and they have responded to every run that Carolina has made. They've come back with a big three or a big two, and these kids have not quit. And I love that spark that they have.
But Thad Mata hit it. Those kids are winners. They've won all throughout their lives, and now they're winning together. I mean, it's just one half, but they're a really solid team.
Yeah, some of the veterans have stepped up, but what's the old saying, talent or experience? Take talent.
You want both.
Yeah,
but
you'll take a little talent.
It's 40 minutes.
48-44 at halftime.
40-minute game. We're only at
halftime. There's talent in that light blue locker room,
thank
too.
Thank you
oh,
very
I'm
much.
Not saying there wasn't. I'm just talking about both teams, actually, when you consider some of the scores we've seen in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Got a barn burner going there. Michigan State and Boston College. Jared Dudley was all over the place at 10 of his first 12 shots.
Yeah, he just takes the game over when they need 30 points, 10 rebounds. Here's the go-to guy. Boy, they were up 17, but Michigan State didn't quit.
Sean Williams with the dunk inside. It made it a 10-point edge for BC, and Dudley saw him working inside, now outside.
Well, we continue to see the offense, but the 2-2-1 full-court pressure that Boston College applied into that matchup zone was really critical for them.
65-58, the final. Purdue and Virginia. Matt Payne and his team watching. Sean Singletary, who had 21 on the night, Jay.
Well, Virginia played very well in the second half, but they had some turnovers, took some bad shots, and Purdue really took advantage of it.
Here is David Teague for three. Teague had 14 points. Now Virginia tied the score on free throws by Singletary. And then as the clock winds down to Terrence Crump, way too late. No, sir. 1.2 to go. He puts Purdue up by a deuce, and Matt Painter's team gets a win for the Big Ten. Now the ACC has already clinched the challenge, and here's the finale. Clemson undefeated, taking on Minnesota 22-20. The score there. As mentioned, the ACC has already clinched the ACC Big Ten Challenge for the eighth straight year. Still to come here on the UPS Halftime Report, the big fellas inside, the reason for the emergence of the big man again in college basketball.
The ACC Big Ten Challenge, presented by Papa John's. Order pizza online 24 hours a day at papajohns.com. And in part by Toyota, moving forward. This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
I tempo, entertaining first half. North Carolina, one of the many freshmen on the floor. Brandon Wright going in there. Danny Green going in for the bucket there for North Carolina, one of the veterans for Roy Williams' team. Oregon and Georgetown. Roy Hibbert facing Oregon first two times these schools have met. Aaron Brooks rejected by Hibbert. Second half, Oregon down one. Bryce Taylor had 14, pushes it back and flushes it. Hibbert was struggling, though. Misses in the lane.
Misses in the lane. Just had a lousy night, really. 2 for 7 the field. Jeff Green goes 2 for 4. They combined 4 for 11, only 9 points. That really hurts Georgetown's offense.
Boy, but give Oregon credit. Marty Lunan did a really good job on him inside.
Hibbert, only 9 points. Duck defense was strong, and Aaron Brooks had 15 points. Dribbling the leather off the thing, but getting it up and in.
Had 30 against Rice. Their guard play was outstanding. Taylor and Brooks combined for 29.
57-50, the final. Aaron Gray in Pittsburgh taking on Robert Morris. Not sure if you guys are aware, but Robert Morris is one of the signers of the Declaration of Independence.
No. He prefers Bobby.
Was up by 4. Robert Morris was down by just 1 point. Derek Coleman, not that one. Different one. Robert Morris taking the first lead of the game, but Gray would come up big, Stacey.
He did come up big, but Robert Morris controlled the tempo of this game. Gray was great inside, but LeVancefield, give him credit. He shared the basketball. A very good point guard for Jamie Dixon.
And then Gray, look at Gray going all acrobatic here at 21-15.
Yeah, he can do that, but the Pitts perimeter game, 2 for 17, they got to find better shot selection than those threes.
Acrobatic, he was falling down.
Okay, I'm trying to be nice. Why are you so negative?
Oh, hit my guy inside.
Big East State, Glenn Davis. The fact that he got it in, it's acrobatic. What are you going to say to Glenn
the
Davis?
The ball was acrobatic.
Glenn Davis, the big guy.
You're going to say Glenn Davis still weighs too much, eating oatmeal.
I love it. He gets it done, baby.
LSU wins 91-57. Glenn Davis had 15. Ron Lewis inside for Ohio State. Buckeyes.
That was acrobatic. Reese Davis, Mr. Acrobatic.
That's a pretty solid visual evidence of what kind of a first half it was, as exciting a first half as you will find in college basketball. Ohio State 48. You're working up a sweat. We saw Kansas, Florida, really high-level stuff on Saturday. This game is right there with that.
Oh, there's no doubt. Yeah. I think right now when you look at Ohio State, can they continue shooting the three? Made 8 threes in the first half. I think 2 key players. If North Carolina is going to win this game, Terry has to step up and make shots. And Brandon Wright, we did not see. Now, 2 fouls early, played only 6 minutes, and he's too talented. He's multi-talented. I think Wright and Terry have to elevate their games in the second half, and they got to be the guys that help North Carolina get to the winner's circle.
Terry did not score in the first half. Hunter, who spent a lot of time on the bench with foul trouble, misses the turnaround. You would think the pace of the game favors Carolina because they have superior depth, but Ohio State traded blow for blow with them in the first half.
Those kids can run all day long. Let's run, baby, run for these kids from Columbus.
Here's Ron Lewis, who was the high scorer in the game in the first half with 15, but misses the layup there.
I really like his game. He and Butler have been the heart and soul. You talk about the fact that is great look. Great look. Brandon Wright to his buddy, Tyler Hansbrough. And North Carolina knocked it on the door.
Ohio State led by as many as 10 midway through the first half.
They made those 8 threes. How big that is. 8 threes and a half.
In 13 opportunities. 5 different players made a three, made 1 or 2 threes for the Buckeyes in the first half.
3-point shot has revolutionized the game. Yep.
Multiple ball handlers out there, Connolly and Butler. Connolly seems to be able to get inside whenever he wants, but Hansbrough is waiting for him.
Hansbrough, good timing. There's Lawson pushing the ball up the court. Brandon Wright's going to want the ball a little bit.
Hansbrough wants it.
He's big-time All-American. Made by one Rolls-Royce team. Plays with heart, plays with passion. A coach's dream.
Hansbrough into double figures now with 11. We're all tied up at 48.
Big possession right here early in the half for Ohio State. And stop a little of this momentum.
Lewis. And I think Terry got a finger on that shot.
They're going to have to stop this little momentum. North Carolina's starting to play. This kid's a great player.
Oh, a block by Hunter, but the follow is there. Terry's first points of the game, and Carolina leads.
Terry and Wright have to contribute. Good timeout. Good T.O.
On their feet at the Dean Dome, a 6-0 run for the Heels to start the second half. Back in Chapel Hill, Carolina has stepped it up defensively, and they've used that for a 6-0 run to start the second half. For more on Carolina's defensive adjustments, here's Doris.
Solid inside defense that time by Hansbrough, but the topic of discussion was their perimeter defense doing a better job contesting shots. Look at Rayshon Terry get up in his face. They want to play harder and smarter. They did a bad job getting sucked in on dribble drive, guys, so they want to keep the guys in front and contest shots. They knew coming in Ohio State was pretty good from behind the arc.
Doris, when you look at North Carolina, they've had a problem defending the three. Teams have been shooting about 40% from the trifecta. The reason is the dribble drive and the kick out. They have to play better on the basketball and not allow penetration.
And they're getting it done right now.
George, definitely. Great job to cut off penetration. Roy Williams got into their heads in that locker room. He had to because they're doing a better job defensively.
Lewis is called for the offensive foul. And Terry is shaken up after taking the charge. Terry, a senior, a guy, Dick, in his first couple of years, hardly played, but once that great class of May and McCanson felt and moved on, he worked himself into a situation where he became a really solid performer and was a starter, 14 points per game for them last season.
Well, he did really a great job, and so did David Noel. How good did David Noel get? He's now playing in the NBA with the Bucks. In fact, North Carolina, as Terry gets up, has 12 players in the NBA, people like Carter and Felton and Haywood and Jamison and May, McCants, McGinnis, Knowles, Stackhouse, Wallace, Marvin Williams, and Shamon Williams. George Lynch in the house played in a 93 team that won the national title. Donald Williams was the MVP in a Final Four. They had Eric Montross on that club. Michelangelo's second national title.
Won another one under Roy Williams just a couple of years ago. Ellington. And the rebound ripped down by Hunter. They've got to keep him on the floor. They need as many big guys out there to defend Hansbrough as possible. Nobody got back and defended Conley. Everybody raced to the rim, and he had an open look. Held ball, North Carolina ball.
That's a nice scrapping and clawing. Spoke to Butch Davis at halftime, the new football coach. And I said, Coach, you got to embrace this football environment and recruiting. He said, you better believe it. See, and that's what Thad Mata's done a great job. He's embraced football. In fact, all those diaper dandies on the Texas weekend 2 years ago, they were there as juniors, and then they decided to go to Ohio State in the spring.
I know you've been preaching that for years, that coaches at schools like Texas and Florida, Rick Barnes, Billy Donovan have embraced football. Wide open look for Ellington, the birthday boy.
Ellington can shoot the rock. He squares his body. Lawson and Ellington will become household names on the triangle.
It's a 9-0 run for Carolina out of the half. It's 53-48 for the Tar Heels.
Now it's important that Butler and Tuck and Lewis are the guys to provide the offense, the veterans.
Lighty with a nice dish inside to Hunter for the layup.
Hunter got the layup, and what a pass by Lighty. Penetration again. Penetration really creates problems for North Carolina.
Lawson, a little hesitation, and draws the foul, I believe, before the shot.
What a nice Christmas present, though. Think about the fact you're Thad Mata. Yeah. All of a sudden, Christmas, here it comes, and Santa gives you a nice 7-1 superstar, who I think, you know, based on coming out of high school, three of the most ballyhooed high school arrivals as big people were Ralph Sampson, Patrick Ewing, and Alonzo Mourning. I think this kid is going to be as good I also feel that with this freshman class, you look at 10 years from now, it's going to be the deepest class in all of
you're talking nationally.
Yes,
nationally,
sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
That is Greg Oden, a two-time National High School Player of the Year. 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, nobody's saying for sure how long until he comes back to play.
Cincinnati, Cincinnati. And I'll tell you this, as great as a talent he is as a player, he might be a better person.
December 16th, they'll take on Cincinnati. Ellington, shoot his second in a row.
He can flat out shoot the rock. That type of dandy from the points on the board. He played high school with Henderson of Duke, who's going to be a very good one at Duke.
Eight now for Ellington, one of the outstanding freshmen in Carolina's class. Let's not shortchange the depth and talent in North Carolina's freshman group.
No, that's a special class. They're big time. Wright, Lawson, Ellington.
Lewis steps back and buries the three.
And that's what you need from a veteran player to make the big play.
Look at Lawson.
Oh, just laying on the glass.
And he'll draw the foul. His speed is going to wreak havoc with the opposition this season.
Showtime. A little showtime.
56-53 Carolina. We'll visit with the head coach of the Carolina football team when we come back. Here in Chapel Hill, Carolina leading Ohio State by three. What a great basketball tradition they have here, of course, at the University of North Carolina, hoping to take the football program to those same heights. Here's the new coach, Butch Davis, alongside Doris Booth.
A man who's had success previously on the collegiate level. There were a lot of big jobs open in major college football. Why Carolina, coach?
Well, Doris, I thought that this was a great opportunity. It has absolutely everything that you're looking for in a football program. Great academic credibility, great fan base. It's got absolutely great access to athletes in the state of North Carolina. Fans are unbelievable. I think it's just a great opportunity.
Ohio State, great football program, both our men's football program and the basketball team, number one in the country. Matt Brown, over his last 2 years here at Keenan Stadium, 10-1. What's the ceiling for Carolina football?
Well, I really, truly believe that this is a school that you have an opportunity to win a national championship. It's not going to happen overnight. It's going to take some work, and there's a lot of work to do. But with all the things that are here, you really, truly can build the kind of program that you'd love. There's no reason that Carolina can't be like Ohio State, Michigan, Texas. Great basketball programs, playing for national championships, and great football program.
Roy Williams told us you guys had a conversation recently. What was the discussion about?
Well, we just talked about, you know, the University of North Carolina, you know, his willingness to do absolutely anything he can to help the football program, and myself doing the same thing for him. He didn't need my help. They're playing great tonight. But just what it's like, what a special place it is, and, you know, it's just a great opportunity.
Coach, congratulations. Wish you the best.
Thank you, Doris.
Dan?
Dick?
I thought it was a great choice. Dick McGuire made a phenomenal choice getting Butch Davis. Knows a lot about intercollegiate football, coaching down in Miami.
Well, while Doris was speaking with Coach Davis, Lawson missed a couple of free throws. Lewis, two more points for the Buckeyes. He's got 20, and Ohio State responding. And getting right back into this game, now trailing Carolina by only one.
Well, the guy that stepped up was Lewis, and that's what you expect out of your veteran player.
Yep.
He's been through it.
A fifth-year senior.
They won the Big Ten title last year, regular season. Lost the tournament to Iowa.
Right, nice pass inside, but Thompson traveled.
Thompson was effective in that first half. Gave us some good point production.
Yeah, they got some good work off the bench. 28 of their 44 first half points came off the bench. Hansbrough, Roy Williams' plan, Dick, is to play him a little bit less this year because they're deeper and because they're going to play at a quicker pace.
Well, because they're playing at a faster pace, they also want him a little rested for coming down the stretch. I thought Gideon and Green gave a big lift in the first half.
Hansbrough averaged about 34 minutes per game last year. Lewis.
What a great look.
And Hunter wasn't ready for it or just couldn't handle it.
Right idea. Now, can you imagine dropping us off to Odin? It'd be slam, jam, bam. But they're going to be dancing in the aisles in Columbus.
Can't wait to get there for that game, January 27th, part of the Saturday night crew as Ohio State will take on Michigan State. We're also going to see Ohio State up in Madison in early January. That's going to be a great basketball game.
Well, Tucker and Taylor and certainly Bo Ryan will do all he can spread that court, get some good shots. People in Madison love their basketball.
Conley driving, kicking to the wide open. Harris for three, and Ohio State is back on top.
And that's what we talked about earlier. Norris pointed it out as well. The dribble, the drive, the kick out. Excellent job by the cerebral Michael Conley. What, yes, his dad was the triple jump Olympian.
Brandon Wright with the jump hook to tie it up.
We haven't seen him yet tonight. Played 6 minutes in the first half. Got two quick fouls. He's long. He's lean. He's got length. He's athletic. He's agile. He's mobile.
He was the three-time Mr. Basketball in the state of Tennessee. Harris with the answer at the other end.
They really come after you with the trifecta. North Carolina early in the second half did a great job containing it.
Dick, they're 11 for 18 shooting threes in this game.
Take a look at Conley right here. Freeze it. Freeze it. See, he gets in the gap. You can't let a guy get in there and he's going to kick it out. You've got to be able to stop that penetration. You can't allow that to happen.
And you talked about how that's been North Carolina's weakness,
yes,
defensively.
Sir.
That really plays into the hands of one of Ohio State's strengths.
Well, we talked about that today at the shooting. They allowed 40% from the three.
Frazier nailed a couple of threes in the first half, a miss here, and it's wrapped up by Daquan Cook, the outstanding freshman from Dayton, who's averaging better than 17 points per game.
Conley really can handle the run.
And,
and he's so unselfish.
And Harris is feeling it, his third in a row.
They call him the microwave. You understand why they call him the microwave?
Vinny Johnson.
Vinny Johnson.
That's right. Heats up in a hurry off the bench. A dozen for Harris tonight on four made threes. Wright showing the other hand this time.
Even hand around the basket. These are freshmen, my friends. They've only been playing college basketball for about 3 weeks. All the AAU competition, travel. Look at this move.
Conley is something else.
Are you serious?
He might have been overshadowed by Greg Oden, but he is something else.
I can't believe. I wonder who won 45 in a row at the high school level. How are you going to beat Conley and a kid like Oden?
Conley's got 6 points and 5 assists in this game.
Either Conley, Oden, Vitale, Schulman, Reese Davis, you can win.
Right with the left hand.
He says right hand, left hand. Roy Williams is singing his praises, that we can understand why.
Hansbrough's getting ready to check back in, along with a couple of teammates. Absolutely phenomenal basketball here tonight from the outset. Conley, no. And the rebound ripped down by Wright, who's having a heck of a second half. Razor threads the needle to Rayshon Terry, who will go to the line for two.
Excellent transition right there. I love that run, baby, run.
We will step aside. Ohio State getting it done from the perimeter. North Carolina, Dick, countering by going to the rim with Brandon Wright. We got some kind of game here tonight. Number one, Ohio State on the road, playing without the injured Greg Oden, who's due back in a few weeks, getting contributions from everybody tonight, including Ivan Harris.
Well, there's the microwave. He's known for coming off the bench. Shoot the trifecta. There it is. Veteran player stepping up. Nothing but nylon.
We talked about how much they shoot the ball in practice. We talked about how well they shoot the ball as a group. 12 for 20 from beyond the arc tonight.
And don't forget about both these schools. Their women's programs are super. Sylvia Hatchell has the great player Ivory Latta. And Jim Frost has done a phenomenal job at Ohio State. They won the Big Ten title last year.
Dick Harris on the bench with 3 fouls right now. Matt Terwilliger is sitting down with 3 as well. And again, Ohio State has only 8 healthy scholarship players.
Made 12 threes thus far. That'll really make up for a very thin bench when you're making those trifectas.
Rayshon Terry scoreless in the first half. Injured earlier in the second half, has returned.
There's no cupcake city here, baby. These are two Goliaths.
Ellington would have tied it after yet another offensive rebound from Hansbrough.
Always looking to penetrate. He's always looking for a gap or seam. Yeah. Very smart.
Got a tough defender on him right now in Guignard.
Guignard's a tough defense. See, Roy Williams knows if we shut down the point guard, you cut off their offensive efficiency. Nolan Richardson used to say that for years at Arkansas.
Hunter
The follow is there for Daquan Cook.
Daquan Cook, he scores in a variety of ways. He's the Baskin Robbins guy. He's got so many variety ways to score.
31 flavors and his number's 31, right?
Yeah.
Hansbrough, there's the
double
quick double team on him.
Double up. He scored with the double up.
He's amazing. He is absolutely amazing around the rim, how relentless he is.
He has the uncanny way of getting the ball off. Years ago, there was a player at Seton Hall, led the nation in scoring, Nick Workman. He had all kinds of ways to score. Take a look at Hansbrough inside. See, he said, freeze it right there. Freeze it. See his big body sitting in a post. Now they're going to get him the basketball and watch the double up. As soon as you're going to see that double up on him, there's the double up. And now he's going to go through the double up, and he protects the basketball. What he does well, he protects the basketball, seals it off with his body.
13 points and 11 rebounds for Tyler Hansbrough. Carolina down by three.
I keep saying I'm not going to get so excited. How could you not get excited? How could you not get excited?
Cook misses a three. Back comes Lawson. Spent the last couple of years at Oak Hill Academy, and as you mentioned, considered the top point guard coming into college basketball this year. This time the double team pays off. Lighty comes up with a steal.
Nice change of direction.
The dump down to Hunter.
Look at him attack the glass.
Hey, Saturday on ESPN, talk about a great college basketball doubleheader. It's the Basketball Hall of Fame Challenge from Phoenix Game 1, Gonzaga in Texas, then Illinois and Arizona in Game 2.
That's the National Basketball Hall of Fame. John Oliva does a great job up in Springfield, and they're sponsoring that game. Tough to keep your voice, man, with all this two nights of all this emotion and talking.
That's right. And tonight's been something else. Yeah. Lawson was trying to lead Hansbrough, and the ruling is that there was a push from behind. A foul has been called on a fellow Hunter of Ohio State, his third. So all three big guys from Ohio State have three fouls.
And the biggest guy of them all and the best of them all is not in uniform.
You can see wrapping that right arm around the waist of Hansbrough. So now Hunter sits down with his third. Terwilliger's come back in. Harris has come back in. And Thad Mott is just trying to rotate him around and scrape enough minutes out of his big guys.
He had a great attitude today. So no matter what happens here today, I know one thing. Look at Lawson with that unique speed and quickness. As the super guard told me last year, he said, when do you see his quickness? How would Garfield go?
Missed three by Cook, and back comes Carolina with a chance
to take
the lead.
Look at the way he runs the ball up the floor.
Ellington with a travel.
He is so quick from one end of the line to the other. If you don't get back defensively in transition, it'll be a layup dunk drill.
And their MO is just wear you out, wear you down.
Let it run. Frustrated with the turnover. I'll tell you one thing. What a Gonzaga, Heifel, and Rivio. Yep. They were sensational for Mark Few's club in beating North Carolina.
Roy Williams said a combination of the Tar Heels not getting the ball to Hansbrough enough and him not being his normal assertive self to the same degree. Terwilliger a miss, and again the Heels can take the lead.
And also North Carolina's perimeter guys were 2 for 17, yep, shooting the three.
Yeah, Miller and Ellington, their two best outside shooters. Gonzaga is a very good team.
Oh, very good. Yep. We're going to see them against Duke.
On the 21st in New York. Lawson. Hansbrough!
What a great play by Lawson. It's going to be tough to keep him away from that point guard slot. He's got the magic, baby. He's got the gift. He's got the ability to slide and glide. He's got ability that you can't teach. Coach Schumann, and I know you like to teach.
He's got 4 assists tonight, and Hansbrough's going to be piling up the points on the other end of those Lawson feeds.
And Stuart Scott just jumped with joy. He just jumped with joy. He's a North Carolina guy.
You know, another amazing thing about Hansbrough, how often he gets to the line. Not surprising given the way that he plays, but he's averaging 10 free throw attempts per game.
Well, he's going to get to the free throw line. Yeah. He's so aggressive. He seals people off with his body.
You've been here for a lot of Duke games. Have you been here when the building's been louder than this?
It's pretty tough to get any louder than this.
Hansbrough with a block. Here comes Frazier.
Here comes Frazier. I love you.
Lawson on the bench right now is Frazier with a bad foot's coming to spell it. Pull up by Ellington. Washington.
Big time shooter. One of the premier diaper dandy shooters in America. The golf is right again. The super golf is right again. He sent me a scouting report on Ellington.
A dozen for Ellington. Harris the miss.
Oh, what a great effort by DeRozan.
Conley is fouled. Foul against Carolina. The Tar Heels have been on a roll, and Roy Williams' dismay has turned to joy with the play of Hansbrough and friends.
ACC Big Ten Challenge is presented by Papa John's. Order pizza online 24 hours a day at papajohns.com. And in part by the new LS, unprecedented, allnewls.com. And A Diamond Is Forever. This Christmas, say everything without saying a word.
Tonight's game is being broadcast on ESPN HD, presented by Olivia. Outstanding game it's been, and how great it must look for those of you with HD, because this has been some kind of basketball here tonight as we bring you to our PlayStation 2 game track from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Back and forth they've gone. Number one Ohio State, number six North Carolina. For those of you who haven't seen some of these great young talents, some of these great freshmen, they have lived up to expectations tonight, but it's been guys like Ron Lewis, Ivan Harris, Tyler Hansbrough, some of the somewhat older guys who have also played their tails off here tonight.
Oh, there's no question.
Jamar Butler, the floater. Shots are not falling the last few trips for the Buckeyes, despite some good looks.
Well, a little better effort, though, defensively. I ask you one question.
Yes, sir.
No matter what the score is here tonight.
Oh,
Mr. Terry. I told you he's going to be a contributor. He and Wright. I ask you one simple question. No matter what the score is, how good is Ohio State going to be with Mr. Odom?
Baseline jumper for Harris on the feed from Butler. Well, there's no question they have to be considered among the best three or four teams in America.
I'll tell you how good they're going to be. They're going to be frightening.
Yeah.
Frightening.
Ellington. Oh, he's going to be frightening.
Ellington can flat out shoot the rock. If he and Terry start making threes, this club's game goes up a whole level.
11 in the second half, 13 in the game for Ellington. Deep three not there for Harris. Great job blocking out by Hansbrough, who's got a career-high 13 rebounds.
We always talk, Dan, about danger points in the game. It's a danger point right now for Ohio State.
Six and a half to go. Hansbrough!
Oh, he's going to need a T.O., baby. They are right now on fire. They're executing. Little Roy doing a dance. He's making like the wish to call.
The Tar Heels on a run here the last couple of minutes to open up their largest lead of the game. A 13-4 run, and the All-American and Tyler Hansbrough is showing all of his stuff here tonight.
Hey, Dan, we're only right now in late November. You know how much better these teams are going to be as you're watching Hansbrough operate inside the Super South? Led the league in scoring, only the fourth guy, I believe, at North Carolina to lead the league in scoring.
18 points, 13 rebounds, and you ask anybody who's played against him, his motor never stops running. I thought Jay Billis put it very well in a game earlier this season. He said his skill is significant, but his will exceeds his skill. He's just got some kind of motor.
He really does. You know, the three guys that have led the league in scoring have been Michael Jordan, Antoine Jameson, and McCants. He has a chance to join that group. The reason you don't have kids at North Carolina leading the league, they usually have balance. Who makes the big play?
Ron
the veteran
Lewis.
Player.
He's
the
got veteran. 22 to bring him back within eight. Let's go to Doris Burke for more.
Well, guys, you talk about Tyler Hansbrough and how locked in he is on training. Well, the loss in the NCAA tournament, as you see the jump shot, not good, had a major impact on him. I said, for 5 minutes, you stood and you faced your locker. You couldn't even look at your teammates. What were you thinking? He said, I thought I was going to work harder than I had ever worked. Impossible to believe, guys. He said, when I didn't feel like working out, he said, all I had to do was think about that loss. This is a guy who's clearly focused.
steal as the diaper dandy. Oh, he lost his balance.
That's
he almost
okay.
slipped.
That's okay. He got the deuce.
He almost slipped.
Remember, we said at the beginning of the game, he's turning 19 today, and he said, I'm going to go out and get 19 points. He only had two at the break. He's got 15 right now.
Well, 19 looks like a lot. Psycho Tito's been the guy inside. They call him Psycho T. Tyler Hansbrough. Bad model, not happy there at all. That's okay. That's okay. We'll play him in March. Our lineup will change a little bit. We'll change our lineup just a little bit. We'll put a seven-footer in the middle.
There's a great note in their game notes. It says Matt Terwilliger is playing mostly in the middle, but he figures to play power forward later in the season. That's because they're talking about Greg Oden coming back, a guy who some feel will be the best player in the country by the end of this season, even though he's a freshman. As you talked about, it's an extraordinary freshman class across America, with or without Oden being healthy right now.
I think it's an amazing class. I think it's going to be the deepest class when we evaluate it after 10 years that we've really ever seen. I love the class of 79. That was a special class. I mean, it's really, when you think about Durant and Budinger, and think about the likes of Oden, Cook.
Floater by Harris, trying to keep him in it. But again, pretty good looks that were falling earlier for Ohio State. They have hit their first cold spell of this game.
Getting a better, doing a better job executing North Carolina. Getting the ball in the hands of the right people, starting with Hansbrough.
Lawson back in at the point after Frazier gave him a couple of minutes off. Shot clock under 10, less than 5 to go. Carolina with the ball and a 10-point lead.
Those veteran players certainly so important in North Carolina, as well as these young kids.
He's special.
They are special. He and Ellington, I mean, there's no question. All the gurus of recruiting, the Bob Gibbons of the world, are 100% right when they talked about these kids in Ohio State being the best classes.
10 for Lawson, largest lead of the night for the Heels. Lewis with a bounce in his step. He'll go to the line for two.
What a great jump stop.
How is this guy the sixth man on his high school team?
I know. But you improve. You get better and better. Yeah. You develop. Better and better. Really gets great triple threat position right there. Spots the gap. And there's the jump stop. Takes the ball up strong. Now I got a message, okay? I want Kirk Herbstreit to listen to me. I want Chris Spielman to listen to me. I'm going to tell him why college basketball is head and shoulders better than college football. You know why?
Why?
Because in college basketball, the little guy, the little team, has a chance against the Goliath, the David, the Oral Roberts, the programs like Gonzaga. They have a chance. You have no chance in football for the mid-major to go out and beat Ohio State, Michigan, Notre Dame, and Southern Cal in football. Well, case closed. College basketball gets the edge.
Okay. And the other reason, I know you feel this one just as strongly, and it applies to Ohio State here tonight. Even if they lose tonight, it does not cripple their hopes to win a national championship.
After the first 2 weeks in college football, 90% of the schools are eliminated from chasing the dream of being a national champ.
Ohio State's going to get a great player back soon in Greg Oden, and they are going to be a national force this year.
I'm teasing this. I love Kirk and I love Chris.
Lawson the miss. Here comes Lewis, 2-on-1 with Hunter.
Nice look. Great look. Hunter from out of Tampa, played at Hillsborough Junior College.
Terry the pull-up. Dick, this baby ain't over yet. Numbers for the Buckeyes.
Look at him run. Look at that run. Oh.
What a play by Conley, and what a great effort there by Lawson defensively.
Two of the better high school freshmen in America. I mean, in high school last year, two of the better point guards.
Three and a half to go. Carolina leading by 8.
Don't go away. This baby's not over.
Back at Chapel Hill, along with Dick Vitale, Doris Burke, I'm Dan Schulman. An 8-point lead for Carolina over Ohio State. We've seen some phenomenal freshmen here in this game. Let's look at some of the great freshman classes, in your opinion, of all time.
Well, we can't put all the names, but 79 had Isaiah Thomas as well, Dominique Wilkins, Worthy, Byron Scott, Stepanovich, Sidney Lowe. I love that class. You look at Alonzo Mourning late in his class. But I think when it's all said and done, This year's class, 2006, with Budinger and with Odin and with Lawson and Ellington and Wright and all these young kids, I think this could be the deepest class of them all.
How about this guy right here, Daquan Cook with a deuce, and don't go away. The Buckeyes certainly haven't. They're back within six.
They have such guts and heart, these kids, and they love playing with each other. We saw it at the shoot-around.
Brandon Wright is fouled, and he will shoot a couple.
Dad Mata has built something really special. But don't forget this. Ohio State's had some pretty good basketball success over the years. Gary Williams did one heck of a job when he was there. Jim O'Brien, he allowed his heart to get in the way of his head and made a mistake and made something happen. Anybody knows Jimmy O'Brien? Beautiful people. And I just hope he resurfaces somewhere and gets an opportunity again because he's good, good people.
Brandon Wright averaging better than 16 points per game. Has his 8th point here tonight.
Hey, you think about Ohio State in the 60s. They had guys like Havlicek
Lucas.
And Jerry
yeah.
Lucas and Bobby Knight. Bobby Knight.
Two big free throws for Brandon Wright, just like the freshman Darrell Arthur hit a 6 big ones for
yes,
Kansas
sir.
Against Florida Saturday in Vegas.
He was my Viper Bobby in a week on my website. You go to it right now.
Who's on it today? Lewis, what a night he's had.
The
three more for Lewis.
Every time they need a big play, he has responded.
A long two, making a long two for Ron Lewis, a game-high 26.
I'll be shocked if he's not all Big Ten.
Deion Thompson getting some minutes here late in the game for North Carolina.
Played well early in the first half. Show some patience. Usually in a 5-on-5, teams struggle when they're so talented and young like North Carolina.
Dick, they've got 4 freshmen on the floor right now, along with Ginyard, who's battling for that offensive rebound. It'll be Carolina basketball.
You know what? There's my freshman name. I'll tell you that.
2:26 to go here in a barn burner of a game in Chapel Hill. Number 1 Ohio State on the road, taking on number 6 North Carolina. Dan Shulman, Dick Vitale, Doris Burke bringing you one of the big games of the ACC Big Ten Challenge, which has been claimed officially by the ACC yet again 8 years in a row.
I can't wait for Saturday night. Coach K's club taking on the Hoyas at Georgetown. Tampa Indoor Stadium, always one of my favorite places as kids really get after it.
And we'll have it for you, 7 o'clock Eastern on ESPN2.
I think we're going to see them get a little bit more in sync when it comes to it.
Right in sync with Lawson.
What a long lead, talented player. What a second half he has.
This one, and they get it from Ivan Harris.
He's microwave, makes big shots.
His 5th 3 of the game brings the Buckeyes back within 5. Foul on Conley.
Conley and Lawson got so much publicity and notoriety on a scholastic level, taking it up to another level now. Something tells me they're going to go to another level. There's the lob over the top. Can't defend that.
6'8 guy with a wingspan about 7'4.
See, right now, kick freezer. Wide open, shooting that 3. All because of the penetration that made that happen. Drive, draw, and dish.
Dick,
the 3 games.
The one area where Lawson has struggled tonight is free throws. Makes that one 4 for 9. That's all in the game. Came in as a 79% free throw shooter.
He was short-armed. He's got to follow through. He's got to get that extension. I tell you again, we've said it time and time again, you can't win without great point guard play. Without a sufficient and an efficient guy who handles the trigger, you have no shot to win.
Carolina with Lawson and Fraser. Ohio State with Conley and Butler, who's at the point right now. Both of these teams are in great shape.
They really are.
Trapped.
Bad area to move the ball.
Well, Carolina stepped it up. Ohio State is in trouble here offensively. Ellington the steal.
He's going to get his 19. He's going to get his 19. He's going to get a W2, baby. North Carolina and Ohio State. Something tells me they're going to be on my list of 4 when asked to pick 4 teams to head to Atlanta.
17 now for Ellington. We saw a great game and 2
Kansas
terrific teams Saturday in Kansas and Florida. Now tonight, Do these two teams, in your opinion, stack up to those two teams? And right now, are those the four best teams in the country? And UCLA, Pittsburgh, there are great teams out there.
We have not seen UCLA in person. UCLA defensively, Jim O'Connell, I trust all these highly respected AP guys, seen that, and he told me their defense is suffocating. Pittsburgh executes so well with Pitino Tobin. And another team, don't forget Ludolfsson's Arizona team. Despite the loss to Virginia, they're an offensive machine. They can score. We'll see them next Tuesday night.
That's right. It's part of the Jimmy B.
Luke's got a new book out, too.
And coming up on SportsCenter with Carl Ravitch and Stuart Scott, Michael Strahan speaks out. Does he ever? An inside look at the frustration for the New York Giants. And Dirk and the Mavs aim for 11 in a row. You having any fun here
tonight? Let me tell you, having loads of fun. But I feel sorry tonight for Carl Ravitch. He has to sit next to Stuart Scott. Stuart's feeling like $1 million. He's strutting. He's working in. Those are my heels. Those are my heels.
93-83. What a game tonight. They've gone up and down and back and forth. Roy Williams says this could be his highest scoring team ever. He wants them to be his highest scoring team.
Yeah, he wants to run. He wants to utilize that bench. He wants to go up and down. He's got the players that can do it. But if they're going to succeed and be a national contender, they have to get better defensively. Yeah. They have to stop penetration. They allow too much penetration.
What do you think Tubby Smith is thinking about right now? The Wildcats are here on Saturday.
Well, Randolph Morris is going to get tested big time by Tyler Hansbrough. And Renee Bradley's going to have to face that pressure. I think Kentucky is going to be better than people believe, and it's said and done. But I think right now they're going through a little growing stage, and they're not a deep team.
Hansbrough, 18 points, a career high, 14 rebounds. Ellington, 16 points in the second half.
So by Lawson, he's waving his hand. He's waving his hand on a Matador defense. I mean, you got to step in and close the driving angle off. You can't let him go right down the cut like that. You got to stop that.
Misses the free throw. The deficit still 7, under 40 seconds to go. All Carolina's going to do is hang onto the ball, make a couple of free throws, and this baby's over. And Lawson will head back to the line as Roy Williams hollers at his team to get over to the bench.
Tell you one thing, they earned this W here today. I know at halftime, many of the Carolina people said to me, hey, I didn't know they were that good. I said, this is only the beginning. I mean, I can't,
for both of these teams.
I can't emphasize to you enough what it's going to mean to put the presence of Greg Oden in that three-second area. Defensively, he's going to be worth 20 points because teams are not going to get layups. The kid's timing is amazing.
Well, as you have said, as you feel, and as coaches have told you they feel, just about everybody says there are only a handful of players who have come into the college game in the last 25 years. A Sampson, a Ewing, a Mourning, even Shaq in high school didn't come in with this kind of a play. There are only a handful of players. There are only a handful of players that coaches who have seen Oden play extensively feel can rank with him at this point of his development.
Well, Mike Krzyzewski, you know, I admire so much. He told us he had him with the USA team.
Yep.
He couldn't practice at all because of his injury, but he said so attentive, so bright, just a great team member. He will be a vital part of the future of our team internationally.
How would you like to have been at this game when Greg Oden and Tyler Hansbrough played against each other in high school? Lawrence North, Poplar Bluff, Missouri, Hinkle Fieldhouse, Indianapolis. Hansbrough had 16 points and 12 rebounds in the game. Oden had 16 points, 5 rebounds, and a couple of blocks. Oden's team won 56-40. Wouldn't it be something to see them match up against one another with a lot on the line in late March?
Might happen in Atlanta.
Yep.
Might happen in Atlanta.
Yeah, right. Maybe in early April. Two of the best big men in the country, even though one of them has yet to step on the floor as a collegiate player. Everybody who sees him says Greg Oden is absolutely special. And Tyler Hansbrough is one of the leading, was one of the leading preseason guys on all the lists for player of the year.
I think a great advantage is the fact they're going to play someone like a Florida at Florida, the Rowdy Reptiles. I mean, it's not cupcakes. I gave my cupcake award last night out to my guy, Larry Eustace in Southern Miss. I mean, they're playing Belhaven, Tennessee Martin, Alabama State, Spring Hill, Sam Houston State. I mean, I could get Ravitch and Scott, Vitale, Schulman, and Reese Davis and beat a lot of those teams.
8-point lead for Carolina.
I'm only teasing you, Larry. Send me some cupcakes.
Conley and Lawson again fouls him, and Les Jones says, Conley, I think he's saying he was on his way up, so he's going to shoot a couple. Lawson, knowing they had fouls to give, wanted to foul him before the shot just to stop the clock. Or not just to stop the clock, just to force them to run a few more seconds of offense.
Take the ball out of bounds.
But instead, Conley, and Roy Williams says, how is that a shooting foul? But that's the rumor.
Roy's got a heck of a staff with Steve Robinson, Jared Haas, right. Joe Holiday.
Let me ask you this as we take another look.
Don't make it tough. There's the drive. There's the drive.
And you can see he was trying to foul.
There's no way that should be two shots. Yeah. No way there should be two shots.
And Lawson talking to Tony Green about that. Lawson deliberately fouled him just to force them to inbounds the ball and run a few more seconds off.
Roy can't believe it either.
It's down to six.
Two possessions with that quickness and that three-point shooting ability. Not out of the woodwork.
And Hansbrough's going to shoot some free throws. Let me ask you this. If you had to vote right now,
UCLA.
How'd you know my question?
Who's number one?
That's scary when
we work together.
Oh, this is getting
We're going
scary.
To have lunch together. Doris picks up the lunch again today.
No.
Oh, you didn't?
I grabbed it out of her hand.
You did?
Yeah,
oh, okay.
You were so busy not fighting over it, you didn't even realize we were fighting over it. UCLA is still your number one team in the country.
Yeah,
ahead of Kansas, Florida, Carolina, Ohio State.
I would pick UCLA because of the wins out of Maui, their defensive ability. I think that Florida, when they get in sync without Corey Brewer right now, I think Florida's going to be one of those clubs.
Yep.
You got to really think unbelievably serious about getting to the Final Four. Kansas, I love Kansas, but I think they need a little bit more help inside.
Yep.
Sasha Khan's going to have to step up his game.
Didn't mention Pittsburgh. Certainly they've got to be in the conversation. Yep.
I've not seen Jamie's club.
We'll see them the 16th of December at Wisconsin. A very tough place to play. It'll be Carolina basketball, and that should just about do it.
I think we're going to have a great year in college basketball. This is November 29th, and we got ourselves a bunch of teams that can make a legitimate run to cut the nets down like Florida did last year.
And you know there are going to be surprises. Florida was just starting to make a name for themselves at this point last year. They weren't really on the Final Four radar coming into last season.
Well, like Syracuse in the year with Carmelo Anthony. We'll see Syracuse on Tuesday night, the Jimmy V Classic. Always special because of the awareness to cancer and Jimmy's golden dream. In fact, anybody would like to help us, just call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V. It's the life you save. Could be someone you love.
Hansbrough to the line for the Tar Heels. He's got 20 points in the game, and he's made 4 of his 5 free throws tonight.
See, North Carolina's got a lot of balance. Bob inside ability with Hansbrough, with Wright, and on the perimeter with Ellington and Lawson and Fraser.
And great depth, too.
Green.
And Stevenson and Thompson, the big guys, give him some quality minutes as well.
The guy we haven't seen yet this year, I think, break out like he did last year, is Rayshon Terry.
Yeah. Very quiet in the first half tonight. A better second half. Another steal. And now Lawson's going to walk it off.
They earned it. Great win. But let me tell you this. The kids of Ohio State are a lot better than I thought. And they're going to have one phenomenal year.
For the 6th time, North Carolina has beaten the number one team in the ESPN USA Today Coaches Poll, the most of any program in America. What a game here in Chapel Hill tonight in front of a capacity crowd at the Dean Dome with Greg Oden only able to watch. But he's coming, folks. He's coming. But Ohio State loses tonight 98-89 to North Carolina. The ACC handily again wins the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Hey, stay tuned for SportsCenter next here on ESPN. And don't forget our post-game extras coming up on ESPN News. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Dick Vitale and Doris Burke, I'm Dan Schulman. Thanks for watching.